بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. So after having read the passage from الدرس الثالث والعشرون last lesson, in this lesson we're going to go over the exercises. تمارين exercises. Exercise number one. أجب عن الأسئلة الآتية. Answer the following questions. كم مدرسا جديدا جاء? How many new teachers came? It mentions here, جاء خمسة مدرسين جدد. جاء خمسة مدرسين جدد. Five new teachers came. The next one, كم طالبا وجد المدرس في الفصل? كم طالبا وجد المدرس في الفصل? How many students did the teacher find in the classroom? The teacher entered the classroom and he said, أرى خمسة وعشرين طالبا فقط. He only saw 25 students out of 30. So we're going to say, وجد المدرس خمسة وعشرين طالبا فقط. The teacher found 25 students only. وجد المدرس خمسة وعشرين طالبا فقط. 25 students only. لمن الكتاب قصص النبيين? To whom belongs this book? قصص النبيين. Who wrote this book? قصص النبيين. Stories of the prophets. It mentioned here, هو لفضيلة الشيخ أبي الحسن الندوي. It is by the virtuous Sheikh Abi al-Hasan al-Nadawi. This is the name of the author. Number four, كم صفحة فيه? How many pages are in this book? We say, فيه تسعون صفحة. فيه تسعون صفحة. In it, there are 90 pages. كم صفحة قرأ الطلاب? كم صفحة قرأ الطلاب? How many pages did the students read? It mentioned, قرأنا منها 53 صفحة. We read 53 pages. So we're going to say, قرأوا, speaking on their behalf, قرأوا منها 53 صفحة. They read from it 53 pages. قرأوا منها 53 صفحة. بكم اشترى المدرس الحقيبة? How much did the teacher buy the bag for? بكم اشترى المدرس الحقيبة? He mentioned here, اشتريتها بثمانين ريالا. I bought it for 80. So we're going to say, اشتراها, he bought it. اشتراها بثمانين ريالا. He bought it for 80 reals. The second exercise, اقرأ الأمثلة الآتية لجمع المذكر السالم. Read the following examples of جمع مذكر سالم, the sound masculine plural. المدرسون في الفصول. The teachers are in the classrooms. So المدرسون جمع مدرس, جمع مذكر سالم. اسم مرفوع هي with واو. أين المهندسون? Where are the engineers? Plural of مهندس. اسم مرفوع هي, so we used مهندسون instead of مهندسين. هؤلاء طلاب مجتهدون. These are hard working students. مجتهدون, plural of مجتهد. أين أحمد وعباس وياسر? Where are أحمد, عباس and ياسر? هم غائبون منذ أسبوعين. They have been absent for 2 weeks now. For 2 weeks. أسبوعين, 2 weeks. It's important that we are able to differentiate between the Muthanna and the Jam' Mudhakkar Salim when they are Mansoob and Majur. Because in both of these, the sign of Jar and Nasb is Ya. There's a Ya that comes and this Ya has a Noon after it. So they look similar. The way to differentiate it is the Haraka of the letters before the Ya and after it. In the Muthanna, you're going to see it has a Fatha and the Noon has a Kasra. مدرسين, مجتهدين, مسلمين. That means two teachers, two Muslims, two hardworking people, and so on. But with the جمع مذكر سالم, it's going to be the opposite. The noon is going to have a fatha, and the letter before the ya is going to have a kasra. It's going to be مسلمين, مهندسين, مجتهدين. مسلمين is a lot of Muslims. مسلمين is two Muslims. مهندسين, two engineers. مهندسين is a group of engineers, more than two. طيب, يَعْبُدُ الْمُسْلِمُونَ اللَّهَ. Muslims worship Allah. So يَعْبُدُ is the fi'l, مُسْلِمُونَ is the fa'il, مرفوع, sign of مرفوع is waw, and لفظ الجلالة الله is the one who is worshipped. لفظ الجلالة comes as مفعول به, the one who is worshipped. هَؤُلَاءِ الطُّلَّابُ هُنُودٌ. These students are Indians. هِنْدِيٌ is the singular. Indian, هُنُودٌ is the plural. This word, we've already taken it. These students are Indians. وَأُولَٰئِكَ بَاكِسْتَانِيُّونَ. And those are Pakistanis. So باكستانيون is one Pakistani. باكستانيون, they've turned it into جمع مذكر سالم. باكستانيون, باكستانيون, talking about males. 3. اجمع الأسماء الآتية جمع مذكر سالما. Make the following nouns into the جمع مذكر سالم. Pluralize them into the جمع مذكر سالم. So مدرسون, a teacher, مدرسون. مهندس, مهندسون. مسلم, مسلمون. كافر, كافرون. غائب, غائبون. مجتهد, مجتهدون. مؤمن, مؤمنون. صالح, صالحون. They are all مرفوع. But we could have also said مدرسين, مهندسين, مسلمين in the case of نصب or جر with the ya. طيب, so you have two options. You choose واو and نون if you're going to place it in a sentence where the word is coming as مرفوع, or ya and نون if it's coming in a case other than الرفع. If it's نصب or جر, then you use ya and نون to pluralize. طيب, اقرأ ما يلي. Read that which follows. So here we learn the alfaz al-uqood. هذه عقود. These are the عقود. عقد, عقود, they called. عقد is tens, tens. عقود is the plural. طيب, so عشرون, ثلاثون, أربعون, خمسون, ستون, سبعون, ثمانون, تسعون. 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. Alfaz al-uqood, they are unisex, so you can use them for both مذكر and مؤنث. For both مذكر and مؤنث معدودs. But you need to remember that عشرون and all of the rest of them, they change in the same way as the جمع مذكر سالم. So you use these forms with the واو when they are مرفوع. But if they are مجرور or منصوب, you have to say عشرين, ثلاثين, أربعين, خمسين, to the end. طيب, and then the معدود from 11 to 99, so it includes all of these, it's going to come as a singular nakira mansub noun. طيب, so طالبان طالبتان, طالبان طالبتان. You can use it for both مذكر and مؤنث. So that's the point of this. That's the point of this. Self-explanatory, inshallah. تأمل ما يلي. Reflect over that which follows. So we have مرفوع, منصوب, مجرور forms. The normal noun, when it's مرفوع, ضمة. منصوب, فتحة. مجرور, كسرة. But the جمع مذكر سالم, when it's مرفوع, we have واو. When it is منصوب, we have ya. And when it is مجرور, we have ya once again. So this is جمع مذكر سالم. جمع مذكر سالم is the masculine sound plural. So it has a singular. It has a singular. And then you add واو and نون to its end, or ya and نون to its end, to pluralize it, to make it into the plural form. And then الفاظ العقود, عشرون, ثلاثون, we don't say it is جمع مذكر سالم because it's not جمع مذكر سالم. It hasn't been pluralized. It doesn't have a singular. So you can't say عشر is 20 and then when you add واو and نون, it becomes plural forms. It doesn't apply. So for that reason, we don't say that it is جمع مذكر سالم because it doesn't fulfill the condition of having a singular form where onto that singular form we add واو النون or ya النون. That condition doesn't apply to these words. So there's another term which they use, which is ملحق. ملحق means it follows. It follows the جمع مذكر سالم in the way it changes. We don't refer to them as جمع مذكر سالم. We have to say ملحق. ملحق بجمع مذكر سالم. It is related, it follows on from the جمع مذكر سالم. طيب. So it changes in the same way. رونا, عشرين, عشرين. طيب, let's read now. دخل المدرس, the teacher entered. سألت المدرس, I asked the teacher. قلت للمدرس, I said to the teacher. دخل المدرسون, the teachers entered. سألت المدرسين, I asked the teachers. قلت للمدرسين, I said to the teachers. دخل عشرون طالبا سألت عشرين طالبا قلت لعشرين طالبا. Another thing we need to pay attention to is these words, they have an i'rab, yeah? When they enter into a sentence, the numbers, عشرون is fa'il here. عشرين is مفعول به. عشرين is مجرور. اسم مجرور for لام. The حرف جر لام. So the numbers, they have a role in the sentence, whichever number it is. But if it was واحد وعشرون, for example, then the عشرين would be معطوف to واحد. واحد would play a role in the sentence. It would be دخل واحد وعشرون. سألت واحدا وعشرين. قلت لواحد وعشرين. So it's واحد مرفوع, واحدا منصوب, واحد مجرور. And then the عشرين would be معطوف, معطوف, معطوف. طيب, it's important to remember that the numbers, they have different i'rabs in the sentences. طيب, number six. أكمل الجمل الآتية بوضع الكلمات التي بين القوسين في الأماكن الخالية. Complete the following sentences by placing the words that are in the parentheses, in the brackets, in the empty spaces. Example, مثال. سألت المدرسين. I asked the teachers. So this was the word that was used, but they changed the waw to ya because now it's coming as مفعول به. I asked the teachers. منصوب. يحب المدرس الطلاب المجتهدين. منصوب. Because it's coming as نعت for طلاب, which is مفعول به for يحب. The teacher loves students who are hardworking. So we say مجتهدين. Make it منصوب. How do we make this منصوب? By changing it into ya. يحب المدرس الطلاب المجتهدين. The teacher loves hardworking students. رأيت 30 طالبا. I saw 30 students. مفعول به. يحب الله المسلمين. Allah loves the Muslims. مفعول به. قرأت 50 صفحة. I read 50 pages. Coming as مفعول به. سألت المهندسين. I asked the engineers. مفعول به. Once again. طيب, number 7. تأمل المثال. Reflect over the example. ثم أضف الكلمات الآتية إلى الكلمات التي بين القوسين. Then you need to make مضاف the following words to the words that are in the parentheses. So this is going to be مضاف and this is going to be مضاف إليه. So the example here says أبناء المدرسي. The teacher's sons. أبناء المدرسين, the teachers, plural, teachers, sons. طيب, so we're going to say بيوت المهندسين. So in this case, it's going to become مضاف إليه, which is always مجرور, right? So مجرور, to make جمع مذكر سالم مجرور, we have to use ya. So we used ya in this case, it was منصوب, مفعول به. In this case, it's the ya is coming again, but it's a sign of جر, because it's مضاف إليه. بيوت المهندسين, the engineers' houses. أمير المؤمنين, the commander of the believers. دكاكين البقالين, the shops of the grocers. سيارة المدرسين, the cars of the teachers. إمام المسلمين, the leader of the believers. دين الكافرين, religion of the disbelievers. طيب, the next exercise is exercise number 8. تأمل المثال, reflect over the example, ثم أكمل الجمل الآتية بوضع الكلمات التي بين قوسين في الفراغات. So after reflecting over the example, we need to complete the following sentences by placing the words that are in the brackets in the empty spaces. We're using these to complete the sentence once again. Okay, the example, قلت للمدرسي, I said to the teacher, قلت للمدرسين, I said to the teachers. So it's مجرور. أبحث عن المدرسين. I'm looking for the teachers. اشتريت هذا الكتاب. I bought this book. بخمسين ريالا. For 50 ريالز. قلت للمهندسين. I said to the engineers. سمعت هذا الخبر من المدرسين. I heard this news from the teachers. هذه الجائزة للطلاب المجتهدين. جائزة is prize. This prize is for the hard-working students. So in all of these cases, they've come as majrur, either by harf jar an, bi, li, min, or it's mudaf ilayhi, coming as mudaf ilayhi. So the sign of majrur, once again, is ya, ya, because it's jam mudhakkar salim. Number 9. اقرأ ما يلي ثم اكتبه مع كتابة الأعداد الواردة فيه بالحروف. Read that which follows, then write out the numbers, the numerical numbers, into words with the letters, and yani spell it out. And then we need to bear in mind that these numbers also, they have the i'rab, they play a role in the sentence. Are we going to make it marfu, majroor, mansoob, and so on? That's what we need to pay attention to. So عندي, this is ظرف مضاف مضاف إليه شبه جملة خبر مقدم. So the number here is coming as مبتدا. It has to be مرفوع. So we're going to say عندي خمسون ريالا. I have 50 ريالز. رأيت, I saw. So this is coming as مفعول به now. رأيت خمسين طالبا في القاعة. I saw 50 students in the قاعة, is a hall, in the hall. اشتريت هذا المعجم بخمسين دولارا. I bought this dictionary for 50 ريالز. So مرفوع منصوب مجرور, the same number. قرأت ستين صفحة. I read 60 pages. This is مفعول به. في هذه المجلة أربعون صفحة. This is coming as the مبتدأ in the sentence. في هذه جار ومجرور شبه جملة خبر مقدم, المجلة بدل, and then this is مبتدأ مؤخر. أربعون صفحة. في الشهر, in the month there are. So this is coming as the مبتدأ in this sentence. So the تسعة, 3 to 9, wherever they are in the sentence, they're going to oppose the thing you're counting in gender. Wherever you see 3 to 9, it's always going to oppose. So likewise here, are we going to say تسعون or تسعتون? The thing we're counting is مذكر, so we have to say تسعتون. And then this is معطوف. So we'd say في الشهر تسعة وعشرون يوما. In the month there are 29 days. أو ثلاثون يوما, or 30 days. This is معطوف to this. This is مرفوع, so this is going to be مرفوع. في الشهر تسعة وعشرون يوما أو ثلاثون يوما. In the month there are 29 days or 30 days. وفي اليوم, and in the day. So ساعة is what we're counting. So we're going to make this مذكر in this case. We're going to say وفي اليوم أربع وعشرون ساعة. And in the day there are 24 hours. أربع وعشرون ساعة. There are 24 hours. وفي الساعة, and in the hour, there are 60 دقيقة. There are 60 minutes. This is coming as مبتدأ once again. So this is مبتدأ in the first sentence. That's معطوف. This is مبتدأ in this sentence. This is مبتدأ in this sentence. And likewise in the last sentence, this is مبتدأ in this sentence. Okay. وفي الساعة 60 دقيقة, and in an hour there are 60 minutes. وفي الدقيقة 60 ثانية, and in a minute there are 60 seconds. ثانية is a second, a unit of time. So let's read the whole sentence. في الشهر 29 يوما أو 30 يوما. وفي اليوم 24 ساعة. وفي الساعة 60 دقيقة. وفي الدقيقة 60 ثانية. هاتي, give, bring. So this is going to come as مفعول به. هاتي 20 برتقالة. Bring 20 oranges. نجح 90 طالبا ورسب 20 طالبا. So the numbers here are coming as فاعل for the verbs, their respective verbs. نجح means to succeed, to pass. رسب means to be unsuccessful, to fail. نجح ينجح. This is ماضي. نجح ينجح. Likewise, this is ماضي. رسب يرسب is the مضارع. So 90 students passed and 20 failed. في هذه القرية 70 أسرة. 70 أسرة. This is coming as a مبتدأ in this sentence. In this village, there are 70 families. أسرة is a family. سني 30 سنة. This is coming as a مبتدأ مؤخر. My age, sin, age. My age is 30 years. سني 30 سنة. My age is 30 years. Number 10. اقرأ ما يلي. Read that which follows. So here, the author, he brings the numbers from 21 to 30 with a مؤنث معدود. We've already covered 21 to 30 with a مذكر معدود. So likewise, just as we mentioned before, that 1 and 2, wherever you find them, they will always match in gender with the thing you're counting. So if it's مؤنث, you're going to say إحدى. مؤنث إثنتان. If it was مذكر, it would be أحدى and إثنان. So these two numbers, 1 and 2, always match in gender with the thing you're counting, wherever they are. If it's 11, if it's 12, 21, 101, 100, or million and 1, or million and 2, they always match. But 3 to 9 will always oppose. This 3, the number 3 to 9 will always oppose the thing you're counting in gender, wherever they are. That's why this does not have tamar buta. They will not have tamar buta because the thing we're counting is mu'annath. If it was the opposite, then you would see tamar buta. طيب. So remember, in when these numbers come in sentences, this is what plays a role in the sentence. This is what that's going to become as fa'il, marfu', mansub, if it's maf'ulun bihi, majrur, is going to have a kasra, and so on. And then this is going to be ma'tuf to it. Follow it in the same i'rab. Ihda wa 'ishruna talibatan, 21 students. Ithnatani wa 'ishruna talibatan, 22 students, female. ثلاث وعشرون طالبة 23 students. أربع وعشرون طالبة 24 students. خمس وعشرون طالبة 25 students. ست وعشرون طالبة 26 students. سبع وعشرون طالبة 27 students. ثمان وعشرون طالبة 28 students. تسع وعشرون طالبة 29 students. ثلاثون طالبة 30 students. This word ثمان is the same as غالٍ. When it's مرفوع, you see it like this. ثمان. And when it is majur, it's going to be like this. But when it's mansub, you see thamaniyan. Thamaniyan. Remember the rules that we explained for ghalin near the start of book 2. We mentioned that because of the heaviness of the dhamma and the kasra on the ya, thamaniyun is difficult to say. So it's removed, and then iltiqaa sakinin, and the ya is removed. And then the last vowel gets passed to the letter before the ya, before its removal. So that happens when it's marfu and when it is majrur. But when it's mansub, it's not difficult. So you can say thamaniyan, thamaniyan. طيب, okay. اقرأ ما يلي, read that which follows. ثم اكتبه مع كتابة الأعداد الواردة فيه بالحروف. Then write the numerical numbers out, spell it out in words. طيب, في هذا الفصل, the one is always going to match in the thing you're counting. وإحدى, صح, إحدى. إحدى وثلاثون طالبة. In this classroom, there are إحدى وثلاثون طالبة, 31 female students. في اليوم أربع وعشرون ساعة. In the day, there are 24 hours. عندي ثلاث وثلاثون روبية وخمسة وأربعون ريالا. I have 33 rupees and 45 riyals. Once again, روبية is مؤنث. So we make the number مذكر here. ثلاثٌ وثلاثون. And this is the opposite as well. مذكر, so we make it مؤنث. خمسةٌ وأربعون ريالاً. So this is coming as the مبتدا in this sentence. And this is معطوف. رأيته قبل مضاف مضاف إليه. So the number is going to be مجرور. قبل إثنتين. Because the thing we're counting is مؤنث. So we say إثنتين وعشرين سنة. رأيته قبل اثنتين, not اثنين, اثنتين, اثنتين وعشرين سنة. I saw him 22 years ago. حفظت ستة is going to come as the مفعول به, so منصوب. It has to oppose. حفظت ستا وستين سورة. I memorized 66 سورة. ستا وستين سورة. في سورة الرحمن, 8 is going to oppose. So we're going to say ثمانٍ, ثمانٍ وسبعين آية. In Surah Al-Rahman, there are 78 ayahs. ثمانٍ وسبعون آية. في سورة الرحمن ثمانٍ وسبعون آية. In Surah Al-Rahman, there are 78 ayahs. The arrow pointing down is 7. The arrow pointing up is 8. That's an easy way of remembering 7 and 8 in the Arabic language. Down is 7, the lower. 8 is up, the higher number. قرأت, this is going to come as مفعول به, so منصوب. قرأت تسعة or تسعا. The thing I'm counting is مؤنث, so I have to say تسعا. قرأت تسعا وتسعين صفحة. تسعا وتسعين صفحة. I read 99 pages. تأمل ما يلي, reflect over the following. لا أكلت ولا شربت. This is what we said about negating the ماضي using لا. If you want to use لا as a negation for ماضي, you have to repeat the negation. لا أكلت ولا شربت. I neither ate nor drank. That's the meaning that we get from it. Neither nor. ذلك الطالب لا حفظ الدرس ولا كتب الواجب. That student neither memorized the lesson nor wrote the homework. لا ضربني ولا ضربته. Neither did he hit me, nor did I hit him. لا رآني ولا رأيته. He neither saw me nor did I see him. إذا دخلت لا على الفعل الماضي وجب تكرارها. When لا enters upon the فعل الماضي, it's wajib upon you to repeat it. عند الإخبار, if you are informing. Meaning, if you're mentioning a general statement, you're informing someone about something and using it as a negation, you have to repeat it. But if you're using it as a dua, you're making dua against the person, you don't have to repeat it. You can say, لا رآني, may he never see me. لا رأيته, may I never see him. لا أكلت, may I never eat. And so on. It becomes a dua, not an informative sentence. It's not ikhbar, it's a dua. الكلمات الجديدة, the new words. اجتماع, meeting. قصة, a story. قصص is a plural. نبي, a prophet. نبيون is one جمع مذكر سالم. Or أنبياء. This is another جمع تكسير. ثانية can mean the second, or it can mean actual unit of time, seconds. ثوان is the plural. ثانية, 1 second. ثوان, plural. أسرة, family. أسر, the جمع. جائزة is a prize. جوائز is the plural. نجح, ينجح, to succeed. رسب, يرسب, to fail. قاعة, قاعة is a hall. بارك الله فيكم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.